Welcome to a short tutorial on how to complete your CBAP V3 application. This video is from Adaptive US, world's number one IIBA V3 training provider. So as you look at the template, the first page is of course your cover page, which explains a little bit about the document. So I'm going to skip that. We will start with the tab, which is README. In the README tab, it explains you how to go about filling up your template, and it puts certain rules that IIBA expects you to follow when you fill up your application. CBAP application has a lot of content and it should be followed in a structured manner so that your application goes through right first time. So some of the rules that are implemented in the template is a lot of fields will come with red mark, and if you wish to have the data, you must fill in the data, which will convert that into green color. So the moment you see a red color, you understand there is something that you need to provide. Then IIBA expects your project start date and end date to be within last 10 years. That rule is implemented. Your project start date must be less than application date, which is of course obvious. Your project end date also must be less than the application date. So if your project is still active, please use 1 day less than current date for filling up experience with respect to the current project. Then project start date must be less than project end date. That's a very standard validation. And then we provide you a max hour information, which you must honor. Do not try to go beyond the max hours. And it is preferable not to have overlapping dates between different projects. If you wish to do so, then you have to reduce your max hours in a right proportion. So the usual advice would be to add big projects first, and then you can go for smaller projects. So the first tab gives you educational background. The good part is IIBA expects any educational qualification, so as such there is no requirement. Even if you say that you have not completed high school, it will still treat it as green, so you don't have to worry at all. Now we will look at the tab called PD hours, which is your professional development hours, which is provided typically by a training provider which is accredited to IIBA. Adaptive US is a premier education partner to IIBA, and hence our trainings of course cater to the PD hour requirements. There you have to provide the workshop name, the start date, end date, and the number of hours awarded to the training. So for us it's 35 hours, so we have put it 35. Then in topics covered, you should include all the knowledge areas, competencies and techniques. Hopefully your training provider does cover all these aspects. And then you also need to indicate if the training is from an EEP. In case of adaptive, it is of course yes. Then comes a little more difficult aspect to cover your reference details. And these are the information that you need to provide. So one, you need to provide the reference name, email ID, and whether the reference is a current reference. That means you are still interacting with the reference in the capacity that you have indicated. So I have provided two references. The two references must be separate. They all can be career manager, they can be CBAP, or they can be your client. So your references will be contacted by IIBA through email, and they would be expected to fill up a small web form. So it is always preferred that you speak to your reference before you actually put their names and details on the application. And here is a sample letter that we have designed for you so that they put the data in the proper way. Say, for example, they should indicate that they know you for more than 6 months, because IIBA expects that the references know you for a reasonable good amount of time. Two, they should not indicate 3 and 4 on proficiency, because that indicates you are not proficient. Maybe 1 or 2 is okay, but if they indicate majority as 3 and 4, then obviously your application is likely to be audited by IIBA. Then we also have provided the information that the references have to fill in. So in case the references tell you that what is it that they would fill in, all the information is already provided here. So they need to provide their name, details, and what kind of work you did, for how long they know you, what are the candidate's strengths and weaknesses. So here are something that we have provided as a reference, like usually we see people with good software knowledge, so that's obviously a candidate's strength, and many of them actually do not have enough domain or business knowledge, which is a typical weakness that we see with many of our candidates. But your references are free to change the descriptions that they would like to change. Then we come to something called the effort part, which is where many people actually struggle. And we generally recommend to limit your number of projects to 10, because the more number of projects that you fill in, you have to provide details for all those projects. And then usually start with the bigger projects and go to the smaller projects. You must know your project manager's email ID, phone number. So in case you are not in touch with the project manager for the project, please go and search in LinkedIn or any other media through whom you can reach out to the person that you worked with in those projects. So here I have provided two projects, and then I have given the start date, end date, and my project contacts. And then based on the dates, the system gives you the max hours that you can take. By default, we take the max hours as claimed hours. You can modify that as well. And it also distributes the activities or effort along the knowledge areas, because mostly we see a pattern in how people spend their effort. So we have used a distribution, but you're free to change. It's not that it is watertight, but maybe just a guidance for you. And then it also tells you if anything is wrong. So if any of the validations are wrong, it automatically makes the cell as red. So you know there is something wrong with the data which you need to modify. Once you complete all this information, then you have an overall recommendation tab where it tells you whether you have filled in all sections properly or if there is anything wrong. The template also comes with certain info for your exam day, like when you go for the exam, what are the kind of things that you should carry, like you must have two identifications with you, the photo should be clear, what you should not do, in case you, and of course, if you see, it's very clearly saying your expired driver's license or passport, letter of identity from a notary, these are not acceptable. So usually you are expected to carry an identification which is issued by a competent government authority. So make sure that you have two identity available with you, and then the photo and signature are matching with your current photo and signature. So that's about it. This is how you can actually fill up your CBAP application. So far, our experience has been those who have followed the template, none of their applications have been refused. Of course, once in a while, it does go for an audit, but the audits also have come up very successfully. So I'm wishing you all the very best in your application process and hope you can utilize this template to get your CBAP application sorted out very quickly, and then you are ready for your CBAP certification examination. Thank you.